या डिसेंट्री हुआ?
इट्स
मम्स
ओके इट्स
एंड
ओके यू कंटिन्यू।
ओके मैम, मम्स एंड कॉमन कोल्ड वायरस, रिंगवर्म डिजीज एंड एथेंस फूड फंगाई।
ओके सो द नेम्स ऑफ द डिजीजेस यू हैव रिटन हियर। सो स्टूडेंट्स लेट मी टेल यू वन थिंग, इफ यू राइट मैक्सिमम 4 to 5 डिजीजेस, द नेम्स ऑफ 4 to 5 डिजीजेस, दैट विल बी इनफ। ओके
मैम,
नाउ
कैन आई
नंबर
टेल
फाइव।
माय आंसर?
यस सुजान टेल इट।
यस मैम, क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 आंसर। The difference between communicable and non-communicable diseases is communicable diseases. Communicable diseases are spread from one person to another. They are spread by tiny organisms called germs. Examples: typhoid, tetanus, cholera, etc. Non-communicable diseases do not spread from one person to another. Examples: diabetes, heart disease, failure of kidneys, etc.
Okay, that will
and
be
then,
enough because this question will contain maximum 2 marks. So if you write definition and example, that will be enough. Yes, number 4, which diseases are caused by different germs?
Yes, ma'am. The different diseases caused by different germs are bacteria causes typhoid, tuberculosis, cholera, and plague. Protozoa
yes,
causes.
Any 5 names if you write. So you don't need to write separately for bacteria, protozoa. Yes, Ujan.
Protozoa causes malaria and dysentery.
Dysentery.
Virus causes common cold, chickenpox, measles, and mumps. Fungi causes ringworm disease and athlete's foot. I'm
ringworm
done.
And athlete's foot. That is absolutely correct answer. Okay, now number 5. How does the disease spread by air? Junaid Khan. Junaid, you raised your hand.
Ma'am, we will write it though.
Yes, we
ma'am,
will
for
write
the
it.
Phone number questions answer, ma'am. For the phone number questions answer.
Oh, number 5, you can't tell number 5. How does a disease spread
no,
by air?
No, ma'am.
You can't tell it. Trisha Ghosh. Yes, Trisha.
Ma'am, I cannot hear anything.
Okay, okay. You stay there in the class. Okay, maybe due to network problem. You cannot hear right now, but after 1 to 2 minutes, it will be clear, okay?
Ma'am,
now, Trisha, you tell us.
Yes, ma'am. Diseases like malaria, chickenpox, and many skin diseases are human, not this. 1 minute.
Ma'am, you are doing question number 3.
No, we are discussing question number 5. How diseases can be spread by air.
Ma'am, will you write it in the class or only discuss?
Join late.
See, from the book directly, exactly this part you will have to write. Exactly this part you will have to write. Diseases like common cold, measles, influenza are spread by air.
Ma'am, you will send a video to.
Ujan, you mute your device. Ujan, you mute your device.
You
okay, so I'm writing this on whiteboard. You just write that answer.
But ma'am, I have written. Can I match?
Yes, you can match your answer then with this one that we are writing now. The answer will be same as it is written in your book.
Ma'am, I have written it a bit differently.
Yes, ma'am,
okay.
I have also written it in different way, ma'am.
So let's see what is the question here.
Ma'am,
can you all see the whiteboard? You wait, have
answer?
Patience. Trisha, have patience. Just wait. I will come back to you.
Yes, ma'am, I can see.
Yes, ma'am, I can also see.
Yes, ma'am, I also.
Yes, ma'am,
I can also see.
What is the date today?
Ma'am, first. Second, ma'am.
Yes. And chapter?
Ma'am, 5.
5. And this is part C. C5.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So the question is, how does a disease spread by air? Like some communicable diseases like common cold, measles, and influenza some communicable diseases. Like common cold, measles, and influenza. Are spread by air. When we cough or sneeze. Full stop. When germs are spread in air, when the germs causing those diseases are spread.
Then the spelling of cough is wrong.
Yes, there will be a O. So when the germs causing those diseases are spread in the air, they are taken by a healthy person while breathing. They are then taken by a it will be better though you should now you don't need to use it if you can use the term contaminate. Okay, contamination means when it is generally used for the germs when from one person to another person or from one thing to another thing. When the germs just travel from one person to another person's body or from one thing to another thing, that is called contamination. Okay. So now you write, they are then taken by a healthy person and makes him or make by a healthy person and makes him sick. Some communicable diseases like common cold, measles, and influenza are spread by air when we cough or sneeze. When the germs causing those diseases are spread in the air, they are then taken by a healthy person and makes him sick. Here you write, make us sick, though it is written taken by a healthy person, but still you write, make us sick and make us sick. Make us
and
sick.
This much.
Make us, because we are talking about germs. So many germs are there.
Wait, I am writing.
This much only.
Yes, make us sick. Those who have not written yet, they write. If anyone has already written the answer, I'm again telling you, it's not mandatory that you will have to write this one only. You can write it in your own language in a different way also, but the concept or the main topic should be the same. The answer should be correct. It doesn't matter how you write it. The way you write it may be different, but the main concept should be correct or proper. If you have already written in another way, you just check that these points are present or not in your writing. That's it. Now, number six, what are deficiency diseases? What are deficiency diseases? So that is also, that answer is also very easy and clear answer. Number six, students, you write diseases that are caused by the deficiency of any nutrient in our body are called deficiency diseases. So write the diseases that are caused.
Answer, is it mandatory to write the examples, ma'am, like common cold and measles?
No, it's not mandatory, but if you add an example, suppose if only definition is given, if you add the example, it's just, it may be a few extra points, that's it, or a few extra marks.
Ma'am.
For that only examples are used, but it's not mandatory. It will be better if you include them.
Ma'am.
Yes, and who is this? Yes.
Ma'am, I am Somojit.
Yes, Somojit.
Ma'am, what you are doing now, ma'am, I was joined late because for some electricity problem, because their electricity is not here in my area. That's why my router is also not on.
Okay,
ma'am, my network is also bad.
Okay, no problem. Somojit, can you see the whiteboard? Can you see the screen?
Ma'am, sometimes it is going in black.
Now, can you see it?
Yes, ma'am.
So, we are writing the question number C5 and C6 from chapter 5 exercise. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
The diseases that are caused by the deficiency of any nutrient in our body. Okay, are called the deficiency diseases. That's it. Okay. I'm giving you 1 minute. First of all of you should complete this part.
Yes, ma'am. Completed, ma'am.
Completed already. Very good. Okay.
Ma'am, completed.
Ma'am, completed.
Ma'am, completed. Ma'am, now we can do the think and question answer.
Now, number D. Look at the picture or given food pyramid and write few sentences in your own words why it is so important to us. This one we have written previously, right?
Yes, ma'am. Explain.
We have done it. That part is complete. Now, thinking questions. Why should we avoid eating junk food? Now, first of all, who can answer? You raise your hand. You will tell me the answer first, then I will write anything. Raise your hand who want to tell the answers. Why should we avoid?
Ma'am, for the screen, please. I am writing the six number answer.
Okay, let me see.
So,
okay, wait, I'm showing you the screen. Just a second. I have actually... No. Okay, I will send these answers in the study material. Okay, those who have written it, it's okay. Those who couldn't write, I will send these answers. Okay. Now I can see three hands are raised here. Amitrajit Ghosh. Amitrajit, you tell me why we should avoid eating junk foods.
Because
Ma'am, we should avoid eating junk food because junk food contains high amount of oil, which is bad for our heart. And also junk food contains high amount of sugar also.
And so what happens if we eat too much of sugar and fat?
If we eat too much of sugar and fat, then we...
What will happen? We will become obese, right? So
yes,
it will cause obesity. We will become obese. It will cause obesity and some chronic heart diseases. Okay. And if we eat too much of sugar, it will cause diabetes, right? Diabetes means what we call sugar. That is called diabetes. The sugar patients have diabetes, right? And we can also have fatty liver. Fatty liver means our liver will not work or function properly, and it will not be able to break down the foods properly. And in some cases, we can also get some types of cancers. So this is why we should always avoid eating junk food. Okay, your answer is also correct. Now, Trisha. Yes, Trisha. Trisha, can you hear me? Yes, unmute your device. No, I'm not getting any reply. Suhana Parveen. Suhana.
Yes, unmute. Ma'am.
Yes.
We should avoid eating junk food. This is very harmful to our healthy diet.
That's it. Okay, well, you will have to write a little much more about this. Okay, let's write.
And when junk food also contains cholesterol.
Cholesterol, yes. Cholesterol, it's not cholesterol, it's cholesterol. Yes. So cholesterol are not always bad. Some bad cholesterols are also there and good cholesterols are also there. So Ujjan, you wanted to see this part, right?
Yes, ma'am. Now can I see?
Okay. You see this? So we will write in the same page. So students should write think and answer. Think and answer or thinking questions? What is written in your book?
Ma'am, I'm thinking question.
It is written thinking questions. And in your previous books, in the previous classes, it is written think and answer, right?
So yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
And in the next classes, you will see brain bites. But all are same. That means you will have to think and you will have to write the answer yourself. So write the answer. Right, we should always avoid eating too much junk foods. As the junk
ma'am, food junk spelling is wrong. Ma'am, junk spelling is wrong.
Yes, junk spelling is wrong here. It will be K.
Yes, ma'am.
As the junk foods contain much more, don't write much more, write higher. Amounts of sugar and fats.
Mom also.
That can increase the risk of, continue this line, okay? That can increase the risk of, this is a lengthy answer, okay? It will contain 2 to 3 marks that can increase the risk of obesity and risk of obesity, comma, some chronic heart diseases, heart diseases are also called chronic diseases, okay? So that you can understand properly now, this is why I'm using both of the words, chronic heart diseases. But actually, we also call them simply chronic diseases. That means the heart diseases. Okay. Obesity, some chronic heart diseases, and diabetes. In some cases, they may also cause cancers. So, to stay healthy, we should always avoid junk foods. This much you will have to write, and I have told you before also, this question may carry 2 to 3 marks. In long type questions, 3 marks questions, you have seen that they generally come. It may contain 2 to 3 marks.
Ma'am, wait, I'm writing. And please wait 1 minute.
Okay, you write. Can you all see all the answers in this page?
Properly? Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am, properly.
Ma'am, now can I unmute, ma'am? But ma'am, in my screen, ma'am, when you were writing form, ma'am, thinking also, ma'am, it is blank.
Now it is okay?
No, ma'am. From when you were started.
Ma'am, this session is recording.
Yes.
Ma'am, I have completed.
Wait, ma'am, I am writing.
Yes, ma'am, already completed.
Ma'am, it is blank in my screen.
Okay, now the second question. See, we don't have time. We will not write it now. So number 2, what does help in making blood?
Iron.
Tell me.
Iron helps in making blood.
I have written iron-rich foods like green leafy vegetables, pomegranate, and banana help in making blood.
Yes, that is also correct answer. If you write iron rich foods, and the iron is also the correct answer. So yes, you can write iron helps in making blood, or iron rich foods helps in making blood. Simple answer. And now what you will write, what you will send as homework, you will send as homework C5, 6, thinking question 1 and 2. All these 4 answers. Okay. You will send in the
assignment.
Yes, the classwork that you have written now. The classwork that you have written now, you will also send these answers. So that I can check that you have written properly or not. Okay. So C5, 6 and thinking questions 1, 2. All these 4 answers you will send.
Ma'am, which answer you have written, we can send that also.
Yes, this one also you will send. Okay. So students, have you completed writing?
Yes, ma'am. It's done.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, done. Ma'am. It is done.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
So now I'm going to call your names. So everyone check. You can mute and unmute.